Welcome back, everybody, to the second half of this video, where I will be going further into the key concepts of enterprise management, as well as introducing which are the services I would like to provide. So let's go. Enterprise management, as I said in the first half of the video, is a process, a culture, a discipline which impacts and is impacted back by all processes in the organization, no matter whether they are strategic, tactical, operational, or compliance. Also, an enterprise management standard would be composed of two main parts, which are the framework and the process. So let's begin with the framework. The enterprise risk management framework is made up of three basic elements, which are the architecture, strategy, and protocols. All these three elements together form the basis of the framework, which main objective is to support the implementation of the risk management process, as this is shown somehow in this picture. Other objectives of the enterprise risk management framework would be to allow the in and out of data and information across the process, so the flow of information, and also to enable the delivery of those objectives and benefits I explained in the first half of this video. The risk management architecture contains details on the roles and responsibilities related to risk management, but also on the reporting and communication structure. The strategy contains some of the key documents in every enterprise risk management framework, maybe the most important, the central one being the risk management policy. This document shows the organizational commitment towards risk management and also which are the risk management objectives and the accountabilities of the organization. Another central document is the risk management appetite. We will come back to this concept later in this presentation, but I can anticipate this is a central concept in order to perform the risk management process correctly. More concepts related to risk management would be the attitude, the philosophy, objectives, etc. And finally, the protocols, the risk management protocols, are those rules and procedures, methodologies and tools, techniques, etc., that explain how the risk management is to be implemented in the organization. Of course, all these concepts regarding the enterprise risk management framework, the process, the architecture, the strategy, and the protocols will have to be adapted and customized in order to adapt to match the organizational needs and requirements in terms of size, sector, or maturity applying these kind of concepts. All these elements forming part of the enterprise risk management framework could be placed alongside the picture I show in the first half of the video, showing a classical organizational structure and adding this information flow. So for instance, the enterprise risk management policy could be placed here, really close from the corporate vision and mission. The risk appetite would follow, and so would do the risk management process and the controls in order to respond to the identified risk in the process. Also, the risk assurance process, which is really related to what is called the third line of defense or internal audit, would provide assurance back to the top, to the board of directors, that the whole process, the whole framework is working as pretended. All other elements of the framework, the architecture, and so could be placed within this circle, this white circle of informational flow across the organization. It is important to say also that the framework, the process, and the standard itself, they must be not just proportionate and adapted, but also they must be comprehensive in the sense that they should be embedded and aligned to all activities and processes within the organization. Let's go now to have some deeper insight into each one of the three elements forming part of the framework. First one would be the risk management architecture. Within the risk management architecture, we'll find details on the enterprise risk management governance structure, containing details on the committees, the relationships, and the terms of reference governing those committees. We also find details on the organization and the lines of defense, usually three: management, risk management, and internal audit. We'll find also within the risk management architecture details on the roles and responsibilities. So who is responsible for supervision, for coordination, who is to be risk owner, So the one accountable for identifying, managing, monitoring, and reporting on each significant risk. And finally, who is responsible for risk assurance, etc. We also find details on the communication and reporting structure, so which data is to be communicated throughout which channels and to which stakeholder. The next element within the framework will be the strategy. The risk management strategy contains the policy. The enterprise risk management policy, as I said before, is a key and central element in every risk management framework. The policy contains the risk management philosophy, the commitment towards implementing the standard, and also the empowerment to those taking part in that. Another key element, key concept within the strategy is the risk appetite. The risk appetite is central in executing the risk management process and contains details on the risk attitude, whether the organization is risk averse or risk aggressive, the risk tolerance, and the significant risk. How to identify, how to decide whether a risk is to become significant or not. Finally, within the strategy, we have details on how we are going to integrate the framework. So, which are the principles behind the initiative, which is the culture we are going to implement, and how we can measure that culture, and which are the training initiatives that we need to put in place. The third element within the framework would be the protocols. The protocols contain the procedures, so how we're going to implement risk identification, risk analysis, risk monitoring and control, etc. Within the protocols, we can also find the enterprise risk management manual containing the whole data and information regarding the standard. So we have the risk management policy, the strategy, the guidelines, etc. And finally, we'll find here the risk management methodologies. So, for instance, how are we going to implement the risk matrix, the risk self-evaluation protocols, how are we going to implement workshops, questionnaires, internal audit, and so on. A concept that is so fundamental for every enterprise risk management standard is that of risk appetite. Risk appetite is defined as the amount of risk, both positive or negative, an organization is willing to take in order to pursue its objectives. It is a really complex and key concept, which is also determinant in order to be able to analyze and assess risk. So, in order to be able to create, to design, and to implement what is called the risk matrix. Finally, risk appetite must be aligned with corporate strategy and objectives in order to be successful. Now, let's go really fast with the process. The risk management process is a set of activities. They are not really consecutive, they are iterative, which start with the identification of the internal and external context, organizational context. They follow then the risk identification, risk analysis, risk evaluation, and risk response. And there are two activities in parallel, communication and consultation, and monitoring and review. And finally, let's move to the services I would like to provide. I have placed here the relative weight of each set of activities in relation to each other. So for starters, there will be the enterprise risk management maturity analysis in order to understand the current state of the organization in relation to integration, decision-making, risk culture, communication, and governance. From here, we'll move to the enterprise risk management framework and process design. So from the understanding and setting of the context and integration activities, we'll move to the design of the architecture, strategy, protocols, and the process itself. Next step would be the implementation. So we would deliver and set an implementation plan, set up some training activities, integration services, and assistance. And finally, independent services activities are placed here. So for instance, further enterprise risk management development, project risk management services, contract analysis, or training services. Regarding my professional experience and educational background, I'm not going to stop here. I think that you can find every detail I stated here in my LinkedIn profile, so please don't hesitate in visiting it. And these are my contact details. You have here my email address, my LinkedIn profile, and my mobile number. So please feel free to contact me should you have any further doubt or request. I will be really happy to answer. So I think that's all. Thank you everybody for having been there these 10 minutes. I am deeply sorry for that. I promise that will be last time, but I also hope that we will find ways to collaborate. I'm really eager to do so. So, nothing else. Thank you and see you soon. Bye.